So today, Sudath is going to tell you about the journey he has made to what he has achieved or what he has become today, right? Because I've known Sudath to be a very quiet person, right? If I introduce him like this, I got to know Sudath through, we were one big family. And we were all living in the Radhulagama scheme and going into the same church. And Sudath was much older than me, and I was an annoying little kid, if I'm not mistaken. And so all his friends, those big akkas and ayyas, they were all chatty and they were chatterboxes. I remember Sudath to be one of the quietest and one of the most simple guys in the clique, right? So after some time, like about 2 years ago, when I got to know that Sudath was a Toastmaster and that he was delivering speeches and motivating the youth and doing such programs in such caliber, I was actually surprised, because knowing how quiet he was, I was actually so surprised. So now today, he's going to tell us about the journey he has made up to what he has become today, and how he achieved his childhood dream even at the age of 30. I use the word even to say that all most of us think that we need to achieve our dreams in our 20s, or we have to become the person that we want to become when we are in our 20s, completing a degree and all that. But it is never too late. So he's going to tell us a beautiful story. So I would like to warmly welcome Sudath. Now it's all yours. It's up to you. Let's quietly listen to his wonderful story and what he's going to tell us. It's over to you.
Thank you very much, Dilushinangi. It's a grand privilege for me to speak to you today. Talking about your teacher, Dilushinangi, I used to call, and there are loads of things to tell. You all can call me, I'll tell you privately the things, how naughty she was that day, early days. So, I'm really happy, Nangi, that you are in a very, good position, elevated into a great heights, and you have become one of the best teachers, and you have won so many awards in consecutive years. That itself is a grand privilege to listen, and thank you very much for inviting me. Okay, kids. Children, are you ready? Okay, all right. I can see a lot of dreamers are here. You must be having so many dreams in your life. All of you have dreamed, no?
Yes.
Okay, great. Great.
Yeah.
Oh, fantastic. So I'm going to ask some questions you can answer. Dilushinangi, can they speak? Unmute mics and speak, no?
Yes, they can mute their mics.
Okay, great, excellent. Can you
unmute their mics, yes.
Can you give me the course of...
Yes, please. Yes, I'm so sorry.
So, children, I'm going to show you some, I'm going to share my experience. How I became a speaker, because in your age, I never spoke in front of an audience, or even I thought of speaking. So let's see how it goes. You have given the co-host option?
Yes.
Thank you.
And I have allowed sharing as well.
All right.
We have a lot of guests also today.
All right, great.
Can you
share? Yeah. Okay. Can you see my presentation?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
This is me, right? Looks nice.
Yes.
Am I audible, Nangi?
Yes, we can hear you. Can all of you hear clearly? Yes.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you. Very nice. Okay. Now, I'm talking about a dream. So I can see, when I look at you all have dreams. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
All of you have dreams. Fantastic.
Yes, sir.
Great, great.
Yes,
so,
sir.
Children, now do you know, the researchers say everybody in this world has a dream, some kind of dream to achieve, right? I'm sure some of you want to become doctors, engineers, right? Am I correct? Or maybe artists, singers, speakers, right? So you are into performing art. That is very important because I'm talking through my experience in the corporate sector. While you have your education, the qualifications, the performing arts skill, the soft skills are very important for a person to become successful. So it's very important that you are in a good forum and good institute under the teacher Dilushi. It's very important. So all of you, everybody in this world has some kind of dream. But children, do you know, only 20% achieved their dreams, 80% couldn't achieve. Why? 80% couldn't achieve. Do you want to be in the 80% group or 20% group?
20%, sir.
20%.
20%. Oh, 20%. Choke, choke. Right, but today I'm going to tell you how you can be in the 20%. What should you do? I'm going to share my story. Do you like to hear that? So this is when I was around, say about
seven, eight.
Like you all, no?
Yes.
Good, good. Right. So when I was a kid, I wanted to be a speaker. I liked speaking and I was dreaming to become a speaker. So I'll tell you a nice story. Now, when I was around 10 years of age, I think most of you are around 10 years. So when I was around 10 years of age, one day I was playing with some of my friends. Right?
Yes, sir.
Not that much.
Good. But it's good to play around with your friends. But these days you're locked down, no?
Yeah, sir, that's right.
Yeah, great. So I was playing with some of my friends, and at that time, one day, one of my known uncles, that uncle was working with my dad. He came to my home. And he saw all of us playing and he asked, you know, with his baritone voice, aha, future doctors, engineers. By the way, Sudath, what is your ambition?
Uncle Harry, I want to be a champion speaker.
That's my tone, right? Squeak voice. Then he was laughed, mocked at me. Son, you will never achieve it because your voice is like that of a screaming parrot. Since then, all my friends call me parrot. So children, with that in mind, I couldn't speak even in front of my friends or relatives. My whole dream, my entire dream, stumbled down and down and down. It's completely destroyed. That uncle completely destroyed my dream. So I can remember that day I went up to my dad and I cried. And I told my dad, I'm sure all of you complain, no, when something happened, right? You go and speak to your dad or mom, no? Likewise, I went up to my dad and I cried and said, Uncle Harry told me a thing like this. Then I saw the emotional face of my dad covered with a desperate smile because my dad knew I had a squeaky voice and when I was very small. So my dad knew about it. But he covered his painful face and he smiled and said, son, don't worry. Do you know Uncle Harry is a magician? Uncle Harry can do magic. He is a magician. So my dad said, Uncle Harry is a magician. That's what magicians do. Either they hide something which is already there, or they bring out something which is already hidden. Son, your dream is hidden by Uncle Harry. He has hidden your dream. So don't worry. One day you will find the magician to unleash your dream, to take out your dream. So son, keep your dream alive. Always think about your dream. One day you will achieve. You will achieve. You will become a speaker. So that was a very powerful statement, and my dad encouraged me. So I loved that. But do you know, children? For good 20 years, from age 10 to 30, I was suffering from public speaking. I couldn't speak. I had fear of public speaking. So even though when I grew up, the voice somewhat became okay, right? But yet, I had that destructive statement in my mind. Because of that, I was afraid of speaking in public. I never spoke in front of my classmates during my school days. I'm sure all of you must be speaking and you are into performing arts. You all can do, but in your age, during my school days, I never spoke in front of my classmates. Even after starting my work, until I reach age 30, I never spoke in public. I was so scared to speak. I was so timid and a bit of an introvert character. So why? Because, but my I was doing, my dad told me to visualize your dream. Always think about your dream, visualize that dream. One day you will achieve it. I was doing that. My father wanted me to go to the backyard and visualize that you are speaking to thousands of people. So I was doing that. But the moment I want to speak, that destructive statement always obstruct my dream, my passion to speak. So I was anyway doing, but do you know what happened at the age of 30? At the age of 30, I went to a party organized by a friend of mine. So I met a nice gentleman called Sampath. He was an opera singer. I don't know whether you all know about Dr. Premsri Khemadasa. He was one of the pupils of Premsri Khemadasa, and he had a fantastic voice. So I was amazed with his singing. He sang very nicely with a powerful voice. So after singing, I can remember he was telling my friend, he can improve the voice of any person as long as that person could talk. Wow, I was super excited. I jumped and asked, Sampath, can you improve my voice? His name is Sampath. So he said, he didn't answer. He moved away from me and grabbed his guitar. So I'm going to show you what he said to me that day. You can you all play an instrument? I hope some of you can play instruments.
Yes, sir. I'm able to play the guitar. Yes, sir. I can play an organ. Oh, great.
I can play the piano.
Ah, super. Fantastic.
I can play the piano.
Oh, great.
I can play the piano.
Do we have singers here? Those who can sing?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Ah, yes, you like to sing a song? Okay. Anyone who like to sing a song?
Yes.
I can give a chance, right?
Is it Chaviru? Yes.
Part of a song? Why don't you sing? Before I, right? Yeah. A part of a song. Who's going to sing? How is Indokhi and then?
You belong, bosses in the world, the vibe that you wanna call. We would start at each other. Cause we're always in trouble. You know, the cool kids did their own thing. I was on the outside, always looking in. Never said I wasn't. And I really keep I wasn't. We all needed someone who forgiving eyes looking back at me from the outside. Like you understood me, and I'll never let you go. We all needed someone who gets you like no one. That's right when you need him the most. We all needed salt to cry on and run through the highs and lows. Gonna make it a la 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 la. I'm not gonna make it a la 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 la. I'm not gonna make it a la 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 la. I'm not gonna make it alone.
Well done, well done.
Oh,
give you a big round of applause. Just fantastic, Puta. What's your name, Puta? What's your name? What's your name, Puta?
Nim.
What is it?
Nim.
Nim.
Nim, Nim.
Ah, well done, Nim. I'm really glad to hear that, and you sang very beautifully. You'll be a good singer, right? Definitely you'll be a singer, right? I'm really glad to hear that song. Well done, well, fantastic job. Okay, now I'm going to tell my story. Now, what did that operaski told me? I asked him, Sampath, can you improve my voice? That was, I'm around 30 years of age. Huh? I'm an uncle at that time, right? So he said, he played a single note and asked few questions. This is a single note, note C. How do you all feel it? That day he asked few questions from me, so I'm going to ask those questions from you. I cannot hear them. Can you all hear?
Yes, sir.
So when I play this single note, how do you all feel it? Nothing special, no? It's not beautiful, no? I mean, it's just a sound. I'm playing a B, G, D, A, D, F, E, C. Now, when I play those notes individually, one by one, do you sense any beauty in it?
No, sir.
But when I combine all those notes together.
No.
So when I combine all those notes together, that sounds okay.
It's
huh?
Beautiful.
Yes.
Oh, yes,
beautiful.
Sir.
Beautiful. Beautiful, yes. So children, now when all these notes playing together, it's beautiful. Not like playing single note. And he said, I have a voice issue, no? He said, imagine, this is your voice. Just, and he said, having a mere voice will not take us anywhere. So like adding notes in music, we need to add color, tone, modulation, breathing, variation, all this into your voice. Then your voice will also be a beautiful melody.
Wise men say only fools rush in, for I have fallen in love with you.
So he sang that and I felt like I had conquered the whole world. That day, he explained me the importance of improving the voice. So I felt like I had conquered the whole world after singing that. And he said, so that if you really want to improve your voice, all these segments related to your voice, you need to practice with me. So children, do you know, from age 30 to 33, 3 years, I practiced with him. To break the shackle I had, break the barrier I had, psychological barrier. මම යා කවුරුත් තුනක් ඒ අංකරුත් එක ප්‍රැක්ටිස් කරා. වොයිස් එක හදාගන්න. I think you all in your organization with the teacher, I think you all must be doing that kind of exercises when it comes to performing arts. So 3 vigorous years I practiced with him. Not that easy. I have to do a lot of exercises, sound exercises and breathing exercises, even some physical exercises. And there are some interesting incident happened when I did those exercises. So children, the lesson is that I'll tell you one incident. He gave me a sound exercise like this. Mame mi mo, mame mi mo. So he wanted me to do these exercises and he said, don't be shy. You have to do, even at home or wherever you go, you have to do those exercises every day. So one day I used to, when I go to the office, so around 5 o'clock, people after leaving the office, so it is only me. So I used to do those exercises at the office most of the time, make sure that everybody leaves. So one day, say around 5:15 p.m., so everybody left the office. So I came out of my cubicle and I made sure everybody left and there was no one there into my vicinity. For me, it was my exercise. Mame mi mo, mame mi mo. Mame. It was then only I realized there was a girl sitting behind the partition. She stood up, took her belongings, and ran out of the office. To make it worse, that was her first day in the office. Mama yage boss eya hithuwa danna mona unada kiyala me manasata me pissu kiyala hithanda samara. She ran out of the office. So do you know what happened next day? She didn't come. And the day after, again she didn't come. So fortunately or unfortunately she never came back. Yeah, then pass office ekata aawena man dakke na yaha it was great. Palin dawas. But yet, still, I do those exercises, children. Because if you really want to achieve your dream, despite all those obstacles, you have to continue practicing your dream. Oh, very important. If you want to become a speaker, find out the things that are necessary to become a speaker. Maybe to improve your voice, maybe expressions. Very important. So, as a result, today I'm a speaker. I'm standing in front of you. I'm a Toastmaster, motivational speaker, and sustainability coach. Apart from my main profession, that is, I'm an accountant. I'm working as a finance director. But I've spoken to about more than thousands of people to change their lives. So imagine, children, until I reached 8:30, I never spoke in front of public. මම කවදාවත් පන්තියේ ළමයි ඉස්සරහ අපිට කතා පවත්වන්න නැහැ. අවුරුදු 30 වෙනකන් ඔෆිස් වලත් මම කවදාවත් කතා කරලා නැහැ, කතා පවත්වන්න නැහැ. So but after the age of 30 only after I found this the vocal trainer, then I became a Toastmaster. So after I became a Toastmaster, I have achieved my dream of becoming a public speaker. So I'll share you a formula I found through my journey, life journey. Now, this is called threefold code. Tum pota lanuak kiyala hala thiyana lanu thunak ekata thibba. This is a single code. Can you all see? So when you take a single code, if someone put effort, can break it. නේද? එක ලණුවක් කඩන්න ලේසියිනේ. තද කරලා කඩන්න පුළුවන්. නමුත් තව එකක් එකතු කරලා when you add another code to it. මේ දෙක එකතු කරලා fold කරොත් එහෙම කොහොමද? Difficult to break, but yet if you put a lot of effort you can break it. But when you add another code. ලණු තුනක් එකතු කරලා හැඹරුවොත් it's simply It's not breakable at all. Simply unbreakable. Amaru karanne. Neida. කොහොමද මම මේ මේ මේක මගේ මේ ඩ්‍රීම් එක achieve කරන්න මම පාවිච්චි කරේ. දැන් මම share කරන්න යන්නේ ඒක. Right? මේ single code එක you and your dream. මගේ ඩ්‍රීම් එක තමයි මේ single code එක. So in my childhood I had a dream of becoming a speaker. Right? So I was visualizing. Your dream has to be extraordinary, innovative, righteous, larger than life, futuristic, closer to heart. So it is something where you like to achieve. So you all have dreams. So the dream has to be you're close to your heart and something passionate about. So that's why, I mean, if the parents are here, I'm telling the parents, maybe teachers also, find out the passion of your child, then allow for that. Then dula putara athi mokhari mokhakari scene ekak samahada amma taattata doctor kinek ko karanna one una namuth oyage dream ekak wen ekak wenna. So always pursue that dream, find out that dream and pursue it. So kohomada dream ekak build up karaganna. In my case, I took my dream into a picture. My dad told me, son, always visualize. Take your dream into a picture. Or visualize and go to the backyard and imagine that you're speaking to thousands of people. Then you have a dream. Take that dream into a picture. Why you should take it into a picture? Any thoughts? ඔගලගේ ඉස්සරහ ඩ්‍රීම් එක මොකක් හරි පින්තූරයකට පින්තූරු නෑදලා තියනවා. Anyone who has written that who portrayed your dream into a picture, take your dream into a picture. Suppose if you want to become a doctor.
SM means like draw a picture of your dream.
Yes.
Sir, I did, sir, but I do not have it.
Why somebody stole it?
No, sir. I forgot where I kept it.
All right, okay. Then it's good that you have already portrayed your picture. That's really good. That's really good. I'm really happy to see a child like that. So take your dream to a picture and hang it in a place where you can see. ඔයාලට පේන තැනක මේ පින්තූරේ තියන්න. Take your dream. If you want to become a good speaker, right? Good public speaker. If you want to get rid of nervousness and to become a public speaker, take it to a picture and hang it in a place where you can see. Maybe in front of your bed, or maybe in your table, you can keep it. Always, and look at it every day and live in your dream. Look at that dream picture for few minutes and imagine that you are there. If you want to become a speaker, just imagine that you are speaking in front of an audience. If you want to become a doctor, imagine that you are a doctor. A few seconds, few minutes, you can imagine that. And the most important thing is don't let anyone destroy your dream. Don't let anyone to destroy your dream, even to your parents or even to your teachers, maybe your friends, you try to destroy the dream. Now, what happened in my story? I had a dream. But when I was around 10 years of age, my dream was completely destroyed by one of my uncles. How did he do that? Son, you will never become a speaker. Your voice, you have a very squeaky voice, he said. So that the words are very powerful. So if parents are here, maybe teachers, parents, and elderly people are maybe here. So make sure don't ever destroy your child's dream. If your child wants to become a fisherman, let him to become a fisherman. I'm not they're talking about a fisherman of bicycle and malukar anime. Fisherman with modern technology. Why not? A carpenter with modern technology. So it's very important. So take your dream into picture. Don't let anyone destroy your dream. Matakai neda? Adama adaganda pinturakata waka mokadda wenna yanne kiyala issara. Eka illanda peena tanaka nithrama thiyala tiyanne. Hamthisse meka diha balanna. Wara pray karayin passe wara balanna puluwan everyday neda? Udeta hawata pray karana hadi neda? Balanna. And kisima genakota e dream eka destroy karanna denna epa. Da putek kiwa putek kare duwek kare kiwa neda dream eka pinture neha kiyala e wara eka hoaga neka tiyagena wara hondata consciously eka diha balanna. Very important children. Now the next code is a mentor. Now first code is the dream, then the mentor. Why you need a mentor? Then it's very formidable. When you have potawal dekak thimoth kadanna amaru wage, what a mentor kenek ona? What a support? Who is a mentor? A mentor is a person who will support to achieve your dream. Mentor is a person who will support to achieve it. So children, always have a mentor along with you. Who are the ideal mentors? Your parents, your mom, dad. They are the best mentors. And your teacher. So we are with teacher Dilushi Pereira. So one of the fantastic mentors you have got. So stick with her. Could be a good relative who always supports you. Or a good friend. අම්ම තාත්ත වෙන්න පුළුවන් ටීචර් කෙනෙක් වෙන්න පුළුවන් හොඳ ඥාතියෙක් වෙන්න පුළුවන් හැමෝම නෙමෙයි සමහරක් ඒගොල්ලෝ ඩිස්ට්‍රොයි කරනවා ඩ්‍රීම් එක and හොඳ යාළුවෙක් වෙන්න පුළුවන් ඔයාව නිතරම ගොඩනංවන යාළුවෙක් එහෙනම් දූල පුතාල මොකද කරන්න ඕනේ ඉස්සෙල්ලාම ඩ්‍රීම් වාට ඉදිරියට වෙන්න ඕනේ එක පින්තූරයට ගන්න ඩ්‍රීම් එක take your destination into a picture then have a mentor along with you so always associate a person who supports you. In my life, I want to become a speaker. Who are the mentors I had? Isala mage kawda? Matakada man kiwa taatta mata kiwa neda? Mama andagena kiyama taatta my dad told me, son, don't worry, you will find a magician to unleash your dream. One day you'll become a speaker. So those encouraging words very important. So if parents are here, always make sure to encourage your child to achieve the dream. So always, children, associate people who support your dream. Kaurari dream ek hadala danawana oyage dream ekata yanna denna naththam yawa eka taraha wenna epa eya idi kandike angili gaha ganna right amen. So in my case, my father, dad was the first mentor. Then I found the vocal trainer to come out with my voice issue. Then I met Toastmasters. So these three I consider as my mentors to help me to become a speaker. So in your case, you have your nice institution is there and your teachers are there, and especially teacher Dilushi is there, so she'll help you. Right. Then I'm going to share a story of another achiever. Before that, I'm going to give you some exercises. Then come in here. Niti mata idda. Mata pain na neke nere life pain na. Okay, now I'm going to give you exercises to break your nervousness. I'm sure you must be doing these exercises in your institute, but as a speaker, to come out with this issue, I did these exercises. So this will break your nervousness or fear of failure. The katha karanda baya nan e baya na baya vena nervousness ek wata e bayak thiyena nan e baya nethi karanne. So I'm not going to give you breathing. I'm sure you all must be doing breathing. Am I correct, Devishi?
Yes, we used to do a lot, but with the circumstances is a bit difficult at times, but we do on and off.
Great, excellent. Yeah. So children, if you really want to become a good public speaker, if you want to excel in speaking, to break the nervousness, breathing is number one, right? When you breathe, I'm sure you must be doing that. I'm not going to talk about breathing much, but always take a deep breath in. Try to make sure that you are filling your lungs with air and breathe out. Keep it for a while and breathe out. So you all can do that breathing, and I'm sure you must be doing now at the moment. And the next exercise is for your lips. So if you, especially when it comes to public speaking, your lips have to be, kept, the active, or the blood flow in the lips have to be strong. Otherwise, what will happen when you go in front of an audience, you find dried lips. So you can't speak, you're stuck there. So to get rid of that, I'm going to give you an exercise for your lips. It goes like this, and you must be doing now these days. Very easy, right? Any guesses? It goes like this. When you drive a car, what do you all do? ඔගොල්ලෝ පොඩි වාහන එලවන ඇති නේද චූටි එකකින් ගන්න අර සෙල්ලම් කාර් එලවන්න නේ නැහැ මොකද කරන්නේ
බ්‍රූම් බ්‍රූම්
බ්‍රූම් that is the exercise I'm going to give. Can you all do? Super. Very nice. Right. So that is one exercise, right? Do this as an exercise. Good. So when you do this, what will happen? You can your nervousness will slowly go away from you. You can get rid of your nervousness. Well, make a karadi me to me told me what me exercise when exercise with the blood flow එක හොඳ වෙනවා. එතකොට it slowly you can eradicate your fear. So it's very important. Now the next exercise is your tongue, divata. ඒ exercise එක කරපුවම ඒකත් voice එකටත් හොඳයි, facial expression on the as a speaker. And you can get rid of your fear of speaking. මේක මම ඔයාලට දෙන්නේ මම කරපු exercises ඉඳන් to get rid of to improve my voice and to get rid of fear of speaking. You put your tongue out, at the same time look up like this. I hope you get it. Me yoga exercise ekak karala thiyenada? Put your tongue out.
No.
Yeah. Dibe eliyada hemota pain ekak gannapo oy coding karanna right? But this is a good exercise. Put your tongue out, at the same time look up. So this will exercise all your facial muscles and tongue, very important. Your face is very important, children, to break the nervousness of public speaking, right? Mataka e exercise anith exercise ekata mehem podi mehem me karanne ne muna mehem massage karanne me widiyata. It goes like this. Easy, ne? Easy. So that will also exercise, you are giving exercises to all your 43, if I'm not mistaken, there are about 43 muscles related to your face. Very important, very important. Now the last exercise I'm going to give is this. So first is breathing, then for your lips, then I gave for your tongue, and I gave an exercise for your face, the massage. Yeah, the next one is for your diaphragm. I'm sure you must be doing, but if not, you keep it in mind. Have you seen dogs panting? Mallekon hati da. Have you seen that? Ah, correct. Ah, right. Good. Good. Very good. Do it private, right? And keep your tongue line in a palate like this. in your palate. Yeah. Make sure that your diaphragm vibrates. A very good exercise. This will also eradicate your nervousness. So hope you all can remember those exercises, right? Matagadi
kiya
bolte.
Yes, sir.
Make sure to remind those exercises during the lessons hereafter.
Yeah, please. And I'll give you another two sound exercises. Especially, this is for your voice. And this will break the nervousness as well. This goes like this. I told you already. Ma, me, me, mo, ma, me, me, mo. I hope, Nang, you can remember this. No? This goes... Take a deep breath in. Always make sure when you make your sound, it should come from your tummy area. You know, like this. Ma me me mo ma me me mo. I think since you have a recording, you can remember this. You can go through this, right?
Yes.
Right. That is one sound exercise. The next one is. Tahati, tahati, tahati. Tahati, 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 tahati. So I think I gave about 6 exercises. Do those exercises, very important, children. These are the exercises I did to come out of my problem. Especially the voice issue, I just came out, I broke the nervousness and it's helped me a lot. So I'm sharing that. Now, I'm going to, before I end this session, I'm going to show you two people who have achieved, who have done wonders in this world, who have achieved greater milestones. The first one is, have you heard about Wilma Rudolph? Wilma Rudolph wahala thiyena?
No.
Right, I'm going to tell this story. I have a video ekak pennanna yanne oyalanta. Asa video ekak balanna. You like to watch a video of Wilma?
Yes, sir.
3 back. Right, okay. Now, before that, I'll tell you who is this girl? Wilma Rudolph.
I say, sir, is she an athlete who has polio?
Ah, great. Who said that?
Suhansit, sir.
Who?
Suhansit, sir.
Ah, right. Why don't you give a big round of applause? Well done. Great. Well done. Okay. That's the child. Okay. Puta, can you tell the story to us if you know a little bit about her?
Sir, she was having polio from a young age, so she was like being distressed. So later, so after that, she wanted to stop. So she learned how to do sports. So she actually went to 2 coaches. Yeah. And trained. After that, she started to do athletics and she went to world champion level.
Exactly. Olympics. Very good, Puta. Thank you. Yes, this is her picture. She was born premature. It's called the premature birth. And she was very weak when she was born. Very weak child, very small. And do you know, she has got all kind of diseases in her small days. Her immune system was weak. At the age of 5, she had polio. She's using a pole to walk, right? So, and she was wearing a brace, iron brace. And she was very weak. And what do you know? What did doctors say? because she is the 20th child of a family of 22 children. ළමයි 22ක් ඉන්න පවුලක 20 වෙනවා. එයාට අක්කලා නංගිලා ඔක්කොම ගත්තොත් එයාත් එක්ක 22ක් ඉන්නවා. එතකොට her father is a porter. Porter means a coolie වැඩ කරේ. ඒ වගේම her mother is also did some odd work. ඒගොල්ලන්ට සල්ලි තිබුණා. They are very poor. And what happened was, I mean, doctors said Wilma will never walk. She'll be a very weak child. Sometimes she might die. Right? So the doctors told her parents, now you don't worry about it. You have a lot of children. Right? But her mother said, no, I'm going to make my child walk. Right? And Wilma also had a strong picture, a dream picture, to walk and to become an athlete. So at the age of 9, she was telling her mother she wanted to play basketball. Yeah, basketball gahanda ona kiyala kiyana. So mother was so worried, and mother said, okay, you play along with your brothers and sisters, because he had a lot of brothers and sisters. Te egulange ayyala akkala ekka selan karagena. She said, no, I wanted to play for the team, college team, school team. And because she was pushing, so her mother took her to the to practices. So the coach was there and the children was there. And everybody laughed at her. Because she was weak and small made at that time. And everybody laughed. But the coach said, come, daughter, come, you practice. So 2 years, she practiced. She didn't have a chance to enter the team because she was weak, but she has, every day she came for practices. So very important to learn, children. She never gave up. She came for practice. After 2 years, when she reached the age 12, she can move fast and she's playing well. And she played. She represented the college team. And at the age of 13, she became the champion in first basketball in California in that age category. So what happened next? She said she wanted to do athletics. So she started athletics and she represented USA at the age of 16, United States of America. And she won the bronze medal in one of the 1957 Olympics. And that was... she represented the relay team. Then she said, no, she don't want to. She doesn't want bronze. She wanted to go for the gold. So now I'm going to show you the this video. So you can see how he did at the age of 19, what he did in the Olympics held in Rome, 96, right? I'm going to show. Let's watch it. She won the 100 meters gold medals. This 200 meters final in Olympics. She won the gold medal again. It's 4 in 200 meters relay. So she won 3 gold medals, 100, 200, and 400 meters relay. So imagine, children, what did you learn? She was born premature. She had got all kind of diseases a child could have in her younger days. And ultimately, she was suffering from polio, a weak leg. What did she do? At the age of 19, she became the world's fastest woman. Imagine, she became the world's fastest woman. She didn't grumble her parents. She didn't ask for nutritious food. She never started protesting. But she had one thing. She had a strong picture of becoming the world's fastest woman. She wanted, she had that picture in her mind. And look at her mother. Her mother also never gave up. Even though she was a disabled child, her mother never gave up. If mothers are listening, I'm telling the parents, the mother never gave up. Could have easily given up because she had plenty of children, 21 children, apart from if Wilma was not there. But she focused on a weak child. As a result, she focused and she said, I will some or other make Wilma walk. And can you see, I mean, in the latter part of the video, Wilma was telling, doctors say I would never walk again. But my mother say, I will make her walk. I believed my mother. So as a result, she became the world's fastest woman, winning 3 gold. That's why she had a dream, a strong dream, and she had a strong mentor. Her mother became a mentor for her. So two goes together, very formidable. And her coach became a mentor. As a result, she became the world's fastest woman. Still, I haven't spoken about the third quote. Right. So I'm going to the last video. Like to listen, like to watch that? The video up in it?
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
How are you going to come in and then I want to show another
person. Yes, sir.
Have you seen this guy?
No.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. No, sir. No, sir.
No, sir. No. Then, Fernando, go to back in. What do you see?
Yes, sir. He's a speaker.
Enjoy his life.
Yeah, he's a speaker, but...
Sir, he's a motivational speaker.
Oh, yes, 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 yes. But look at, when you look at him, is he a normal person?
No, sir, he doesn't have...
No, sir, he doesn't have... No, sir, he doesn't have... No, hands and no legs.
Oh, sir, he doesn't have limbs. He doesn't have limbs.
He doesn't have legs and hands.
He doesn't have limbs, arms and legs, limbs. All of you have your limbs to intact, no? Intact. But he didn't have. But what did he do? You are like he to watch this video?
Yes. He didn't give up, but he enjoyed his life.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah. He became one of the best motivational speakers. Right. Look at this video.
When you're in school, when you're growing up in life, it actually sort of matters to people how you look. And then it matters to you because it matters to others. And the fear that we have is that we're going to be alone, that we're not good enough. And, you know, we have to change ourselves. You know, so many people put me down and say, Nick, you look too weird and no one's really offended. You can't do this and you can't do that. And I couldn't change anything. It's not like just fixing my hair one day and everything's fine. I couldn't change my circumstance. I couldn't just one day wake up and say, hey, give me arms and legs. I need arms and legs. It was so hard because people put me down. And I started believing that I was not good enough. I started believing that I was a failure. That I'd never ever be somebody who people would like, people would accept. And it was so hard, man. I thought to myself, like, you know, I can't go on the soccer field like everybody else. I can't ride my bike and I can't skateboard. All these things. I started getting depressed. I thought, what kind of purpose do I have to live? I mean, are you just here to live to die? I mean, is there not a purpose for me? Is there not a purpose in life? And I had questions and no answers. And I asked my mom and dad, why did this happen? I asked doctors, why did this happen? They don't know. There are some things in life that are out of your control that you can't change. You got to live with. The choice that we have, though, is either to give up or go. I want to ask you, what are you going to believe? Are you going to believe in yourself? Are you going to believe everybody else's judgment on you? How did I get from depressed to who I am today? Because I tell you, I was depressed. When I was age 8, I used to concentrate on the things I didn't have. I wish I had arms, legs. I wish I could do this. What can I do? You see, I have a choice. I can either be angry for not having arms and legs or be thankful for my chicken drumstick. And I'm traveling around the world. It's amazing. But I had to ask myself a couple questions. And the first question was really, who am I? Who am I? I'm Nick Boyd, but who is that? Because it's nothing good about having no lips, but I love my life. You want to know why? Because I've seen the purpose. When you see me for the first time, many of you felt sorry for me. Do you feel sorry for me anymore? No. Why? Because you know who I am. But don't you remember I have no arms and no legs? Would you want to be my friend?
So what do you think? He didn't have arms and legs, but he's now one of the most successful persons in the world, a successful speaker, author. Have you seen the things that he's doing? I mean, have you all done the skydiving?
No,
never done, but he has done.
No, teacher.
I mean, no, sir.
No, sir.
I'm sure most of you can swim, but he's swimming without his arms and legs, but he's swimming and riding boats and doing a lot of things. So imagine, he didn't have arms and legs, but he has done wonders in this world. He has become one of the most successful persons in the world. So children, how about you? You have arms and legs?
Yeah.
You have nice parents?
Yes, yes. Yes.
You can achieve so many milestones. So have a strong, formidable dream. And for Nick, Nick's mother supported him. Because she was, when you look at Nick's story, he wanted to get rid of this life. I mean, she was so fed up. And you must have watched in the video, he said, look, you look weird and you look... awkward. So she must have fed up. I mean, that's why he asked doctors, why did this happen to me? Mom, dad, why did this happen to me? He was so depressed and tried committing suicide as well. But his parents, especially the mother, gave him, encouraged him. So today he's a successful man, successful person. So children, what did you learn from today's program? Now, I told about my story.
Don't give up on your dream.
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 Super, super. So for that, what should you do? What should you do? Take your dream.
Don't speak in character.
Take your dream into a picture.
Don't give up.
Take your dream into a picture.
Into a picture, right?
Dreams.
So take your dream into a picture, your future destination. What future ke kawuda wenne eka pinthurata ganna. Right? Eka peena tanaka tiyanne, right? Then the second thing is you need to have a mentor, good mentor. Ammi taatti, the teachers la. what ආදරේ කරනවා වාම ඩ්‍රීම් එකට ගෙනියන්නේ ඩ්‍රීම් එකේ අනිත් පැත්තනේ ගෙනින්නේ ඔයගොල්ලන් ඩිස්ට්‍රොයි කරන ඒගොල්ලන් නෙමෙයි ඔල්වේස් ඇසෝෂියේට් පීපල් හූ සපෝට් යූ ටු අචීව් යෝර් ඩ්‍රීම් රයිට් මේබි යෝර් පේරන්ට්ස් ටීචර්ස් ඇන්ඩ් ඇයි තින්ක් ටීචර් ඩිලුෂි ඉස් සපෝටින් යූ ඕල් ග්‍රේට් දැට්ස් වයි ෂී ඉස් ඕගනයිසින් දිස් ටයිප් ඔෆ ඉවෙන්ට් බිකෝස් ෂී වොන්ටඩ් යූ ඕල් ටු අචීව් යෝර් ඩ්‍රීම්ස් සෝ I just spoke about these two things, a dream and then the mentor. Now, before I conclude, the last thing, the third code. What is this?
Unconditional love.
Unconditional love.
Exactly. So, children, now you can, if you have a dream, if you have proper mentors, you can achieve. You can achieve whatever you want in your life. But if you really want to find the true happiness, they will achieve they're not happy. They have money, work, they're doing really well, they're good professionals, but yet they don't find the happiness. Happiness take a gandanan. When my third code, this is the third code, unconditional love. When you have all these three codes together, it's a threefold code. Your dream is formidable. You are going to achieve your dream. At the same time, you find happiness. So what should you do? What do you mean by unconditional love? Any guesses? Any ideas?
Unconditional love means love which is not measured or done under any circumstances.
Great, great. Well done, well done, well done. Yes, yes, yes. That's true. Without expecting anything, no conditions. Unconditional, unselfish. Without expecting anything, you love people. You love your parents first. You love your siblings. Love your teachers. Love your neighbor. That's what, I mean, if you are a Christian, you know, I mean, Jesus told us that. Love your neighbor. What do you mean by neighbor? Not only known people, I mean all your friends who love them without expecting anything. And when you achieve your dream, always keep in your mind, what is the love factor that I'm going to give? If I become a successful person, you have to show that love factor. You have to express that. So help. What are you going to do? Help to the society. What kind of thing that I'm going to do to the society. So do something good to the society. Try to protect the nature. Do something good to the nature. Do something to your parents. Something better to your parents. Look after your parents. When you grow up and when you achieve your dreams, when you become successful, look after your teachers. Look after the people who supported you to achieve your dream. Show them love unconditionally. Very important, children. So if you have these three, you will become a successful person. You will achieve your dreams. At the same time, you will find happiness. You'll be a winner. You can beat Usain Bolt. This is not me. So thank you very much for listening to me. And do you have any questions to ask? Any questions?
No, sir.
No questions. Hope you all have understood. What are the three things I told you? What are the three things I told you? A dream.
Dream, unconditional love, and
mentor.
Mentor.
Yes. So today itself, try to take your dream into a picture. Right, always look at that and find people who support to achieve your dream. Right, then third is the love factor. Always be a loving person. So thank you very much for giving me the opportunity. Thank you, Dilu Shinangi, for inviting me. And I'm always willing to, if whenever possible, I'm willing to help you all. And I'm really happy about your institute and you have done so well, and you have become best, got become best in the in all Ireland many years. Thank you. I mean, it's a great privilege and wonderful achievement. And thank you very much again. And if you want anything, you can call me anytime. I think Dilushi, sister, teacher Dilushi has my phone numbers and contact number. And you can contact me anytime. Children, if you want any help, if you want to, I mean, if you're struggling anything to achieve anything, just call me. I'm willing to help. And if you like, there is a call, amazingtv.lk. You can watch this. It's a very new TV. I mean, about now still about we have 2-3 programs, but this is an upcoming television channel where it is a development communication initiative aimed at supporting individuals and brands to grow sustainably in their own field of expertise. So you will, I mean, when you grow up, you will learn so many things, how you can brand yourself. So we can give a chance to you as well, Dilushanangi. So you're the TV that is meant for betterment. So amazingtv.lk, you can subscribe and you can watch many good videos in time to come. So thank you very much. God bless you all.
Thank you so much, Sudath. And
Thank you, sir. Bye.
I need to say something. Right. Thank you so much, Sudath. It was more like a very informal, a very friendly, close to the heart discussion. And that was the type of thing that I exactly wanted, because I wanted these younger generation to listen to someone who could speak to their hearts. Somebody who can speak to the bottom of their heart and make them kind of like give them something to take back home. I mean, they're already home, but for them to go back to bed and think, to ponder, and something for them to like dream about. Yes, you beautifully did it, Sudathaya. Thank you so much. And from the moment I called you, you took so much of interest, and I actually did not believe that I'd be able to get hold of you, right? Because during the concert, when we were trying to contact you to get the barrels, you remember, and she and Aya was having a bit of a difficult time trying to contact you.
Such
a busy person. But with just one call, you dropped me a message saying, Nangi, I'll call you back in 1 hour. And the moment I told you, you took so much of interest, you were so enthusiastic, and you said, let's do it. And ideally, this whole week, as I told you, we had presentations, public speaking, speeches. So soon after this entire week of festival of presentations, you selected a date, ideal date for them to talk about public speaking and reaching their goals. So thank you so much once again. My heart is gratitude for spending so much of your precious time with us. And I think if there's any parent who would like to say a few words, you are most welcome to say. I keep on getting messages already. I just read out one message during Wilma Rudolph's video. One parent texted me saying, thank you so much for this opportunity. I really cried. Thank you again. So I know by the end, I will get a few more messages like this. And thank you so much, Sudathaya. And we are also there. Who are planning any more programs? Yes, I'm willing to support, and I am also willing to take part in programs as such with this bunch of naughty, naughty kids.
Thank you. I'm willing to come. I'm willing to come anytime. Yeah.
Yes, thank you so much. Like... Yes, you can tell, sir, whatever you want to say. Yes, you're done.
Dana, come on.
You want to say something? The chatterbox is the Mahunaga part. Right, anyway, thank you so much, and Sudath once again, and thank you all of you for joining this program. I hope you have something precious and wonderful to take back home, to take back to your bed and to dream about. And make sure you draw your dream, take the dream into a picture and hold it and see it every day. So God bless all of you. Night, and God bless all of you.
Thank you. See you. Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.